Hi there, this is a brief video outlining the structure of DNA and RNA. So DNA and RNA are both types of nucleic acid in the cell. They have a lot of similarities, a little bit of differences, which I'll outline a little bit. So DNA and RNA are made up of nitrogenous bases, and I'm going to start with DNA first. So they can be either what's called either the larger, the purine type. Very rough sketch here, or they can be the pyrimidine type, which is a smaller single ring. Okay, and then they're bound to a sugar. So this is the purine type, and this is the pyrimidine type. In DNA, that sugar is deoxyribose. That's where the D comes from in DNA. And the sugars can be oriented in an up or down conformation. So it kind of depends on which side that we're looking at there. This is our sugar. Sometimes this is called a 5-carbon sugar. But the very specific name would be deoxyribose. And then is bound on the outside here to a phosphate. I'm just going to abbreviate that here, but that's a phosphate. And then the same setup on the other side. So you're going to have the sugar. Oops, my color's consistent. And then you're going to have it bound to the phosphate group on the outside. Now, they're bound in the middle by hydrogen bonds. So it depends on which purine and which pyrimidine. So they either have 3 or 2 hydrogen bonds holding it together in the middle. A's and T's are held by adenine and thymine, are held by 3 hydrogen bonds, guanine and cytosine. Oh, got that backwards, hold on. Adenine and thymine are held by 2 hydrogen bonds. Guanine and cytosine are held by 3 hydrogen bonds. So it depends. I just drew a 2 conformation here, so we could assume that that's thymine and adenine based on that. And then the whole nucleic acid is built from, you've got your phosphate kind of in the outer portions of what we call the ladder, and the sugars kind of holding that up. And then across the middle, what we call the rungs of the ladder, are going to be the purine and pyrimidine that are held together. And so in DNA, the purines are either going to be adenine or guanine. And I'm just abbreviating here out of space considerations. And then cytosine or thymine in DNA. And then so you're going to have this long chain of repeating. It's going to look just like this. Remember, in DNA, it's double-stranded. DNA, meaning that there's nitrogenous bases on each side. Uses adenine, guanine, cytosine and thymine. RNA is just slightly different. So RNA is single-stranded, so it's actually just going to be 1/2 of the strand. And don't forget the sugars are different. So in DNA, the sugar is deoxyribose. That's the D part. In RNA, it's a ribose sugar. Now, if you're covering any genetics on viruses, we're going to play up this double and single-stranded conformation, but we're just sticking to the general prokaryotic and eukaryotic cell possibilities. So the RNA is going to be single-stranded ribose sugar. It also uses adenine and guanine as its purines. Cytosine, as one of its pyrimidines, the other one is uracil. So different there, that's a difference. So you actually can, if you're not sure about which substance you're looking at, you can look for not only whether it's single or double-stranded in the sugars, but one of the quickest things to look at is to see whether it contains the T or the U in the chain that's there. And so DNA is going to be what's the kind of permanent inheritance molecule, so that's passed down through the generations. The RNA, then there's different types of RNA, which I'm not going to go into here too much, but the RNA is sort of synthesized by the cell using the information that's in the DNA. And three basic types of RNA, this is not all inclusive, is mRNA, or messenger RNA, and that essentially carries the DNA message in the cell. tRNA, which is transfer, but I often think of that as it translates because it's going to change the nucleic acid message into a protein. So it carries the amino acids during protein synthesis. And a third common type is rRNA. That's ribosomal RNA. So when you've learned about the ribosomes, you might not really have thought a whole lot about what makes up the ribosomes, but a big, big component of that is ribosomal RNA. So it actually makes up the ribosomes, along with some proteins. Okay, and those are the basics, kind of basic comparison of DNA and RNA going through that general structure that's there. Don't forget that you have hydrogen bonds in the middle in DNA that actually makes DNA quite stable. And in fact, if you have a sequence that's really rich in these guanines and cytosines that have three hydrogen bonds, that can even increase the stability as well. It just depends on the area of the gene that you're looking at there. And then you have, so the nitrogenous base is held together in DNA by the hydrogen bonds attached to that five-carbon sugar, which is deoxyribose in DNA. And then the phosphate, and keep in mind these are all stacked on top of each other and then folded into the double helix. In RNA, you have just one half of this because it's single-stranded. It's not that double-stranded molecule. You would still have your purine and pyrimidine, nothing bonded on the other side, there's nothing there. The sugar now is ribose sugar and then the phosphate group on the outside. I thank you very much, and please contact me with any questions.